Metro cities, there are a lot of gaps which exist in the rural and the semi-urban society. Thus we chose a place, his birthplace, that is the Thavulampally Mandal, which resonates in his soul and heart, which has got huge spaces, interspaced with mango groves, with paddy fields and the mystical chantings in the background. That's why we chose the area of Thavulampally Mandal. The second question is, why did we deviate from only healthcare? Why does total health encompass everything? And that is because health per se is very difficult to define health, it's very difficult to measure health. What people are measuring is the absence of health and not health. Health is a state which is brought about, it's a dynamic thing which is brought about by the interaction of the genetic makeup of an individual and how it is allowed to express itself by the environment, be it physical, be it mental, be it social, be it economical, ecological. All these factors come together on how health is expressed or how the genetic makeup of an individual is expressed. And thus, when we decided to make this program, the chairman said, I want a very holistic program from the womb to the tomb, right through the journey of an individual. And thus, we have the total health concept which came about in the year 2013. Now, what all do we do in total health? I'll give you a very brief gist and then just play the video film on it. As far as health is concerned, we started with a survey conducted on the lines of the World Health Organization, steps approach. We identified all the people in this mandal, a total population of about 60,000. We carried out a survey and identified the people with diabetes. We found 6% already knew they had diabetes, another 4% didn't even know they had diabetes, but they were confirmed diabetics. Another 14% are in the pre-diabetic stage. Similarly, hypertension, 27% of hypertensive, another 40% in the pre-hypertensive stage. Similarly, anemia, 26% of the population has anemia. And cardiovascular risk going up from 10% in the age group of 15 years, going up to almost 70% by the time they reach 50 years of age. We did a cancer survey which is ongoing. We have detected to date 15 cases of CA cervix, out of which 12 were detected in a very early stage, operated, and they are living and well. All the operations have been carried out by Apollo hospitals in Chennai and in Chittoor, and all of them free of cost. Secondly, we identified 3 cases of breast carcinoma, operated, very successful, living, surviving for the last 2 years. Then we have, to all these cases we've detected, we've got 2 mobile clinics, 2 satellite clinics to look after them. We cover the entire mandal in a month's time. The entire 195 habitations of this Thavulampally Mandal are covered by the mobile clinics and the 2 static satellite clinics every month. We carry out the basic investigations on the spot there and give generic drugs at very, very subsidized rates. We have done school health examinations, identified 7 cases which required to be operated of VST and AST, which have been operated at the Apollo Hospital in Chennai, all free of cost. Then we have introduced the Ayush system and amalgamated it with the allopathic system. It's working very well, gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, it's working, and it's very heartening to see. It's one of the chairman's vision, although he is the founder of the corporate health, more of the allopathic, but it's always in his mind that we need to integrate the entire Indian systems as well as the allopathic system into one cohesive unit to give the best to each and every individual. Now, besides, we have a collaboration with the state for detection of tuberculosis, detected 65 cases from this mandal, and 4 cases found to be HIV positive in this DMC. We have looked into the water supply. We have provided 6 RO plants and 3 rapid sand filters. Now currently we are only deploying rapid sand filters, which are in collaboration with the Gram Panchayats of that particular Gram Panchayat. And we build it, we put the equipment, and we allow them to operate. They charge a nominal fee of 3 rupees for 20 liters of water, and even supply the water in their households for another rupee. And the maintenance and all comes out of this cost. And I can very proudly say we have about 600 to 1000 draws of 20 liters every day. Tree plantation, the chairman is very, very passionate that the newer generation should get back what he had in his youth, that is going there in the shade, plucking fruits from the trees. And we are carrying out this plantation drive solely guided by his zeal. We have done about 50,000 plantations, and how our plantations differ from others is that we do a, thank you sir, we do a census every 6 months. And we have 85% survival rate. In certain areas, it's as high as 97%. Then we have made nutrition centers for the pregnant and lactating women. And there we, and their children who accompany them, there these women and children are given 1 nutritious meal which looks after their protein content, their iron, and their vitamins for the day. And along with that, we do medical checkups. Along with that, they're made to do yoga, exercises, and given a blitz of health education. Then, from these centers, we've had about 170 deliveries, all of them with no maternal mortality, no deaths. In these last 4 years, which we've done, there has been no death. All of them have been institutional deliveries. And when I say institutional, we encourage them to go to the public hospitals or the Apollo hospitals, where our cesarean rate is as low as 14% compared to what it is 40% almost in the private institutes. Then we have geriatric centers. To date, we have got 3 geriatric centers catering to a population of about 100 people who are aged above 65 years. We provide them a meal, we provide them facilities for indoor games, we do a health checkup, and we are also trying to introduce brown bag making by these people so that they even earn while they spend their time in these centers. And we are upgrading them to the level of almost a club. The chairman was very keen that we reintroduce yoga into this mandal. So we have a tie-up with the Vyasa Institute in Bangalore. We have reintroduced yoga. We are giving the people of the mandal the facility of earning a diploma in the instructor course YIC from the Vyasa Institute. We've asked Vyasa, they have lowered their educational requirements for it because it was very difficult for all the villagers to be 12th pass, so even they are accepting 10th. And we have trained about 60 people, out of which 8 people are actually practicing yoga.